BlocksCAD skills. Working with code. Duplication. Disabling. And enabling. In the same way you might want to copy and paste text or images in a document, there are also times when your 3D design calls for the repeated use of the same blocks and shapes. Take a look at the two blocks we have on our workspace. A 3D shape and a rotation block. To duplicate an entire stack of blocks, right-click, or command-click on a Mac, the outermost block you want to copy, and select Duplicate. You'll get an exact copy of the block you clicked on, as well as any blocks nested inside of that block. Let's move the copy off the workspace and look at some other ways we can duplicate code. You can also make a copy of a single nested block by right-clicking on that block only and selecting Duplicate. Now we have an exact copy of our cylinder block. Okay, let's clear that off the workspace. Duplication can save a lot of time. If you wanted to add a second cylinder to this model that looks just like this one, only rotate it in a mirror image so that the two cylinders form a V, you could go drag out a cylinder block, change its values to be tall and narrow, get a rotation block from the blocks menu and set the value. Or, you can simply right-click on the rotated block, select Duplicate, and now you have a cylinder that's already the right size and ready to rotate. Just change the rotation value from 45 to minus 45, which in a 360-degree arc is the same as 315 degrees. Render, and it's done. Depending on the project and the design you're working on, there may be reasons to disable a stack of blocks that's already on your workspace. To do this, right-click on the outermost block you want to disable and select Disable. Notice that the stack of blocks turns gray and looks muted. It's important to note that disabled code doesn't render, as you see here. You can re-enable the code simply by right-clicking on the top block and selecting Enable. Now the code renders again, and we can see the bottom of our design. Why would you disable your code? Well, lots of reasons. When adding a new shape to a model, we often want to begin working with the shape at the origin in order to rotate or scale it before moving it to its final position. Since other parts of the model may also have been rendered at the origin, the view of any new shape could be blocked. So, disable it. Render, and now you can work on a new shape, like this sphere that we just dragged out. If you right-click on an empty part of the work area, you can select Disable All Blocks to disable all the code and block stacks in the work area. If you only want to work on a single part of a model, sometimes it can be faster to disable everything and then just enable the one part you want to work on. On the other hand, if you want to enable all the blocks, you can do that as well. So, any other reasons we would disable blocks? It's a great way to diagnose overlapping shapes. First, let's disable all so that we can clean up our render view. To demonstrate overlapping shapes, we'll drag out a sphere and a cube. Set the sphere's radius to 30. But before hitting render, let's think about what we're going to see in our render window. Okay, let's render these two shapes. Can you see both the sphere and the cube? Well, that must mean that something is being blocked. If we disable the sphere, you'll see that, just as we thought, the cube was inside of it. Now I know that we'll need to translate the cube to make it visible. We'll start with 15 millimeters. Render, but we see that's not enough, so let's try 50 millimeters. Now, if I enable my sphere, should we see it in the render window? Absolutely. There it is at the origin, with our cube translated out of the way. Large models can often take a long time to render. To show you what I mean, let's take a look at a BlocksCAD example. You'll find these sample projects inside of the Help pull-down menu at the top of the screen. Select Examples, and then the Antheus Fish. You'll see right away that this is a large and somewhat complicated model. Let's see how long it takes to render this. Hit Render, and we wait. And wait. And wait. While the BlocksCAD program does a lot of math and other computations in the background. Okay, there it is. But what if I only wanted to work on, say, the right side fin? It would be a lot faster and less cluttered on my screen if I disabled all the other parts of the model and just enabled the piece I was working on, like this. So a good strategy would be, for larger projects, to disable the parts of the model you aren't working on and speed up the rendering, as well as providing you better focus on the areas that do need your attention. You can watch this skills video again, or, to practice what you've just learned, launch BlocksCAD and start building.